Their participants on guest of the Congress dedicated to the 75th anniversary of the
Nicolae Testimițanu State University of Medicine and Pharmacy. It is my pleasure to welcome you today for the State of the Art Lecture. Our guest speaker is Professor Yusuf Oscul, and he is coming from ERCS University, that is in Kayseri City on Turkey. Now I'll tell you some important career milestones of Professor Yusuf Oscul. He is graduated from Firat University in 1985. In 1987, he took his master's degree from ERCS University. On 1990, he got his PhD at the Gazi University, but by having at the same time a research fellow at the Imperial College of London. After that, as a postdoc, he continued studies at Emory University in Atlanta, USA, and Utrecht University from the Netherlands. In 2003, he became a professor of ERCS University, Faculty of Medicine, Department of Medical Genetics. He has conducted over 80 different projects, and he has appeared in over 250 original works. His area of interest are epigenetics, hematogenetics, transgenic animal models, molecular genetics, cytogenetics, and stem cells. At the same time, I want to mention that team of Professor Oscul, together with team of Professor Gropa from our university, recently got a TÜBİTAK project entitled "The Eccentric Genetic Landscape of Drug-Resistant Epilepsy." Also, I want to inform you that Professor Oscul actively is involved in the new design of our central laboratory building. His today lecture is entitled "Genome Variation in Precision Medicine." Please, Professor, start it.
Good afternoon, Mihail, it's a honor for me, and then to give the lecture about genome variation in precision medicine. I hope everyone is healthy and then everyone is good. Today, I'm going to give you some information about genomic variation in medicine. Let me see.
Микрофону коннектация.
Okay, do you see that?
Коннектация микрофона.
And can you see my presentation?
Yes, we see. You can see. Go ahead, professor.
Can be basically defined as a right patient, right medicine, right dose, and the right time. With the advance in the genetics, molecular variation, biotechnology, proteomics, and imaging methods, the molecular variation of the disease and the response to the therapeutic method. We molecular diagnosis tool that has developed available to guide treatment. It's probably the way for the more sensitive and targeted treatment. The idea of the individual treatment rather than disease has been strengthened, and the personalized medicine is emerging as a result of those. In fact, we can consider this situation as a paradigm shift from classical medicine to the individual medicine of the genomic age. In classical medicine, everybody received the same medicine, and between 30 to 80% effective. Tailored treatment to match an individual makeup and response more effective and favor side effects. Why we are different? What's the main mechanism? Actually, our genetic background does not work alone. it worked the other factors like the environmental infection, disease, sunlight, fever, and the response, all of them together. It means that all genetic background does not responsible for the drug resistance. Drug resistance or drug response will be manipulated, all the factor, including genetic factor together. We are different. A zygote has 2 meter long DNA in the single cells. Adult people has approximately 90 billion cells. We have more than 200 different cell types. Only 1% of the genomes are encoding exons. We have 2,000 genes and 200,000 exons. But it's a shame that all proteins number is much more bigger than the all gene numbers. We have approximately 1,000 different proteins. Look at the exome sequence differences. Two healthy people. If you compare two healthy people, you will find at least 18,000 variants, 9,000 non-synonym variants, 8,000 synonym, 250 variants that cause a lot of functions, and then 100 variants associated with genetic disease. Also, we have de novo gene mutation. The other thing, important thing, that healthy people also has variation. This variation will be on chromosome side or copy number side or single nucleotide side. The healthy people has also 450 variants, 300 non-synonym variants, 100 synonym variants, and 50 variant that cause loss of function. It's very important. 50 variant that cause the loss of function. I'm talking about the healthy people, not ill people. Also, 30 splicing and 20 stop gains. Let's talk about the epigenetics or the epigenetics. We know that there are 4 main mechanisms for monitoring the epigenetics: the DNA methylation, histone modification, nucleosome remodeling, and non-coding RNAs also. Personalized medicine or precision medicine. In the recent years, the term precision medicine has been used frequently. Some authors now use the term precision medicine or the ground that the term personal medicine has become obsolete and lead to misinterpretations such as the development of the individual protection and the treatment for the each individual with it's not possible. So precision medicine can be defined as people with certain illness divided into subgroup with genetics or other analysis, developing appropriate treatment and prevention method for them and then ensure their implementation. Technological development that ensure the advance of the personal medicine. We used to use the Sanger sequencing. Instead of Sanger sequencing, mostly we prefer the NGS sequencing. Actually, currently we also use the Sanger sequencing. Now the way we choose the Sanger sequencing system. So NGS system, I mean next generation DNA system, has a lot of big power. First, it's cheap. You know, $3 billion was spent to complete the human genome projects. Today only $1,000 is enough for the whole genome. Why it is important? NGS can be used not only for the genome sequencing but also in many different areas. Multiplex is also important. It allows many different samples to be collected in a pool and work it together at the same time. Also, rapid is important. Quangular project that at least 13 years was completed to 2003. Today, the genome of 18,000 people can be sequenced annually with the Illumina HiSeq 10. I'm talking about only one machine can analyze 18,000 whole genome per year. Technical development that ensure advantage of the personal medicine. The use of the genomic information in medicine practice is increasing. Based on genomic information, specific disease diagnosis became easier. Diseases are better targeted with specific drugs. Toxicity risks are identified and reduced. Pharmacogenomic science was born on development. Not only the DNA sequencing technology, but also the imaging technology really will help us to personal medicine, especially magnetic resonance imaging, computed tomographies, and positron emission tomography also will help. Also, apart from the DNA sequencing, the gene expressing profile, proteomics, metagenomics, and epigenomics developed in many areas like this have made a significant contribute to develop the personal medicine. And benefit and applicability of the personal medicine. The four main issue. Earlier detection, targeted disease prevention, accelerate diagnosis, and targeted therapies. This is main steps. To make the diagnosis of the many diseases are more clear and consistent, ensure the detection of the disease in early stage, ensure the development of the new strategies in prevention and diagnosis, giving medical appropriation to patients' genetic profile, avoiding excessive and unnecessary use of the low efficacy drugs, preventing the predetermination of the use of the drug that may cause toxicity, decreasing health expenses, increasing pain satisfaction and complication with the treatment, increasing the quality of the applicability of the health system. Choosing the appropriate treatment. Many patients benefit less from the first medicine recommended for them. In 50% of the arthritis patient and 43% of diabetic patient and 40% of the asthma patient and then 38% of depression patient less responsible to the initial treatment in uptight. Why? Why less? It may be unknown that it's caused by changing in gene encoding. Enzyme that metabolize drugs, drug carriers, drug targets. The best example of this is seen in the breast cancer patient. Epidermal growth factor 2, cell surface protein, is overexpressed in approximately 20% of the breast cancer cases and is associated with a poor prognosis. Trastuzumab, as a monoclonal antibody, is used in the treatment of this woman. When the trastuzumab is used in the combination with other chemotherapies, the survival time is prolonged and the currency is decreased. The other example is lung cancer. In lung cancer, you can therapy with antibodies, molecular therapies, chemotherapies, or novel drugs. So molecular diagnosis and treatment with classification of lung cancer, EGFR positive and ALK positive. So these two markers will help you what kind of therapy is going to use for this lung cancer patients. Also, side effect is very important. Medication side effects are important important health problem. While 6 out of 7 of patient percent of the hospitalized patient develop side effect, is among the most common, approximately 5% cost of the hospital lead. Between 1990 and 2012, 43 drugs were withdrawn due to serious side effects. So response to the drug varies widely among patients due to the heterozygosity of the disease. Environmental, genetic factor. Genetic factor can affect both the pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamic properties on the drugs. Those, they can increasing or decreasing local and systemic expression of the drug or changing the function of the drug targeted. Enzyme, the gene and encoding enzyme that metabolize drug, drug carrier, drug targets, and also human locus antigens are largely responsible for the drug efficiency and side effects. Warfarin, I will give you an example. Warfarin is an anticoagulant that acts by inhibition of the vitamin K-dependent coagulation factor. It's used for the prevention of the treated thrombotic disease. CYP2C9 gene encodes one of the main enzymes involved in the warfarin metabolism. In individuals carry at least one copy of CYP2C9-2 and CYPC9-3 alleles. Enzyme activity decreases and result in less metabolism of the drug. Thus, the concentration of the drug increasing and a lower dose of the warfarin is sufficient for the patient compared to the normal CYP2C9 panel. VQOR-C1 gene encodes the vitamin kinase exposed reductase enzyme. Patient carry the 1639GA changing in the gene promoter region are more sensitive to warfarin and should be given lower dose of medication. So, just when you look at this two gene, the drug concentration will be 5 to 7 milligram till 0.5 to 2 milligram. When you compare these two dose, is it 20 times higher. So when you check the which allele the patient has, so you may calculate the warfarin dose very easily. If not, you will lose your patient. Also, the risk management and disease prevention is very important for personalized medicine. You see that for BRCA cancer, BRCA1, BRCA2 gene are very important for the development of the breast cancer. So if a patient has the BRCA2 mutation, 55%. If the patient has a BRCA1 mutation, 65% will be breast cancer. In some paper, if patient has two of them, it will reach 90%. So if when you look at the or check the BRCA1 or BRCA2 gene variation under the breast cancer patient, you will monitor and you will check the patient life very easily. The other example is another prophylactic surgery can be applied in the multiple endocrine neoplasm. Prophylactic thyroidectomy can be performed in the patient with a molecular diagnosis of the MEN type 2A to prevent the development of the medullary thyroid cancer. Compliance also very important for the treatment. Compliance of the patient with the treatment and the lifestyle changing are extremely important to follow up many chronic diseases. in the formation of the common health problems such as heart disease, obesity, diabetes, and for most of the person, and the environmental factor as well as the genetic factor are effective. Some studies have shown that individuals with genetic risk knowledge about the disease are more eligible and reduce other existing risk. In a study constituted that approximately 800 patients with clinical familial hypercholesterolemia, the rate of the use cholesterol lower treatment follow up after molecular diagnosis increasing from 51% to 81%. In other study conducted that 200 smoker participants, it was possible that the smoking cessation and attempt was significantly increasing in case with a molecular diagnosis of the alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. Personal medicine, ensuring the use of the expensive drug to suitable patient, preventing and financial losses due to the side effect, increasing in hospital staying, taking preventive measurement from the disease, decreases and control of health expenditures as an important patent for all of those. In 2009, the American Society of Clinical Oncology recommended that anti-epidermal growth factor receptor therapy be initiated after the KRAS mutation test in patients with a metastatic colorectal cancer, because this mutation carrier does not responsible to the anti-EGFR treatment. Similarly, patient with the BRAF mutation does not responsible to the treatment. So researchers have shown that the KRAS mutation test provide an additional $7,500 per year. And then the BRAF also will save $1,000 per year. Just to check the two mutation, and then every year, approximately you will save $6,000 per year. Genetic tests used in personal medicine. Genetic tests generally focus on three types of genetic changing. Relatively rare sequence variation that cause Mendelian disease, single nucleotide polymorphism, which are risk factor for contact disease, sequence variation that regulate response to the drug. Genetic tests used in the personal medicine, specific single gene test, specific gene panels, genotyping panels for selective variants, whole genome and exome sequencing. By the way, I will say you that all kind of tests have been done or are doing in our genetic department. Every year we accept 7,000 patients from my genetic department, and we give approximately 100,000 results. I mean, results for the patients. So difficulties in the application of the personalized medicines. Bioinformatics. I think that it is a really, really main difficulty. There is a huge data in the interpretation. When you check the any exome variation or whole genome variation, really you will find at least 300,000 variation. So you have to choose which one is the right one. So you need a really, really good bioinformatician. Education. Some of physicians have difficulty in the interpretation of genetic test result. Ethics also is very important. What age should a child be informed about a genetic diseases she or he may acquire in the future? This is really, really very important. Who is responsible? Who is going to give you the news for the child? Pediatrist or geneticist or internal medicine? Who is going to give the news that you are going to be illness because of the genetic variation? Also scientific, we have a big issue about the scientific problem, because the biological factor underlying many disease have not been fully elucidated yet. But we don't know that the most of gene function, and also how this gene work, and then how this gene work with the others. We don't know it. Also the epigenetic factor, and then non-coding RNA also, and the non-coding RNA, so a lot of different factors are working, and then together, and then and mostly we see the result. This is a show that not only the gene, but also non-coding factors, or the environmental factor, or the others. In summary, in the treatment, tactic of one size fits all should be avoided, and new clothes suitable for all sizes should be designed. Classical classification should be changing. Mutation and tumor should be reclassification according to the sequence data, and treatment of the disease should be tailored. Close relatives should be screened and followed more carefully in the hereditary cancers. High risk pathogenic variants measures should be taken for life expectancy and quality. Diagnosis and treatment methods with known effect should not be avoided. This treatment option should be supported by genetic variation. Healthcare professional should be informed in the field of emerging methods such as genomics, proteomics, metagenomics, and standard appropriate should be adapted, especially in the reading and evaluation of the genetic reports. Genetic counselors who can spend more time with patients should be trained. And the last one, the focus should be on the whole population. Thank you. Mihail?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Yusuf, for your nice presentation.
So, you're welcome.
Yeah. Let's go to the discussions.
Yes, is there any questions? And I will let you answer. Yes, there is.
Thank you for a very interesting presentation. As usually you present very common and contemporary knowledge and direction in medicine. How do you think about the stem cell tissue engineering as a personalized components of personalized medicine?
It means that when I get any cheer from you, and then I will give your stem cells for the others very easily. When I transfer the stem cell to the others, all bodies will not give any immunologic response. So that's why you can use stem cells for every people. You can use for stem cells for personal medicine also. Stem cell is not private. The common.
Yeah.
You see that in COVID, we prepare approximately 95 stem cells, and then we transfer stem cells to the COVID patients, and then some of them really will it had to recovery, but some of them not. But the prepared stem cell belong to different people, not patients.
Okay, thank you. And you answer a little earlier. It was a second question about stem cells used in COVID-19, and you answer it. You used these stem cells in patients which were very grave patients, or and which way of injecting of these stem cells you used? It was a intravenous injection or intratracheal?
Yeah, I understood. So there are two ways. One intratracheal, the other is in the blood. Mostly we prepare intravenous. But if a patient connected to the machine, so and then we offer the doctor that you may divide it to two, and then half of them will be given the intratracheal, the others will be given on the blood.
Okay, thank you very much.
It's connected to the machine. If not, we offer the intravenous.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Any other questions?
Thank you for your very interesting presentation. And I think as you became a good friend of our university, this is not your last presentation, we hope. All of us probably understand that personalized medicine is the future of the medicine. And those difficulties which you mentioned in one of the last slides, will be solved, will be found solutions using the efforts of all people from the whole globe, all from our planet. My question is related to your last slide, because you said that should be done some populational researches. Now, because of migration, the population are very, very mixed. Which ways of genetic analysis, which ways of genetic testing can you recommend, taking in consideration the population are not pure, they are very mixed. People are traveling from country to country, so and we do not have a real pool of the genes. It's a mixture of different genes.
My company, within 5 years, we accept 7 million Syrian citizen, 7 million Syrian citizen in Turkey. So 10 years ago, also we accepted 3 million Iraqian citizen to Turkey. And Turkey also is a very, very mixed population. Also, I think Moldova also, I think that has the same situation. So in this situation, we started to do Turkish Genome Projects. Every time we discuss this situation, genome is really represent the Turkish population. The answer is not one, because there are a lot of ethnic groups living in Turkey, or in, on, even if it's German also, 4 million people who live in Germany were born in Turkey. So that's why we can generate more than genomes for at least for my country. I don't know the your country, but at least different countries. But mostly the differences are not in the Mendelian genes, but mostly related to the complex gene on the exons or introns level. You will find the most differences. So I think that maybe to reduce the difference minimal level, you may work with a lot of patient, a lot of healthy people. And if you, for us, we say that at least 100,000 people who live in Turkey will be attend the Turkish Genome Projects. Why? This is very big, because the Turkey is a really, really mixed population. That's why we divided the subgroups, and the people who live in the north side and the west side or the middle side of Turkey and Anatolia, and then we will calculate it together and then separate it together, and then we will say, okay, this is the Turkish genomes. It's not easy to say. Igor, I'm sorry, but it's not easy.
Yes, definitely it's not easy. That's why I'm asking. Yeah, thank you for your answer.
Any other question? Professor Yusuf, I would ask you, did somebody scan the ACE2 gene? ACE2 for angiotensin converting enzyme type 2. Did somebody synchronize it? In Turkey.
Am I right?
Yeah. Go ahead.
I will say you wanna check into the gene variation.
As I know, Igor Chemortan, he did it for ACE1, for angiotensin converting 1. Yeah. So they saw some variations here in Moldova. But I'm asking if you know something about ACE2 gene. You know that some mutation ACE2 genes that make a resistant of the SARS-CoV-2 binding.
Yeah, I know that, but I have to check my department. I'm not sure we are working or not. But I will check it, okay?
As I know, in the Nordic countries, they have the mutations about 2.5% of the population, they have the mutations. But we are also mixed populations here in Moldova, about our history, yeah, you know, that's why I'm asking you.
I think that maybe we are safe, I think that, because when I looked at the COVID patient in Turkey, I think that 67% of the COVID patients hasn't had any symptom. 67, but in PCR, it's positive, but no symptom. Approximately 70% of the COVID patients. And then maybe 10% of the COVID
give it some small favor or something, but 1% of the COVID patients really, really ill. So why the huge variation for the COVID may be related to the mutation of this gene? I don't know though. But I will check and I will tell you, okay?
Okay, thank you very much. Any other questions? We still have 2 or 3 minutes.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Clinical pharmacology, Lucia Țurcan, if I can ask something to Professor Oscul.
Yes, please.
My question is about your opinion about the gene editing technology CRISPR-Cas9. And the possibility to use this new technology in the future for fighting viral infection, including and the COVID.
Yes, actually, the CRISPR-Cas9 technology got a Nobel Prize this year. You know that? It's a really.
Yes, because of this, I asking you.
Really, really wonderful technology. But We work with the CRISPR-9 technology in Genkirk, and actually we're working with the mouse now, and then we get good result. But this technology in some time will put the additional a tail at the end of the DNA.
Yes.
So, I think that to knock down by using the CRISPR-9 gene is good, but to repair, maybe we will have some problem for the human. But we are trying. But this technology is really, really powerful technology to repair a single nucleotide polymorphism or single nucleotide variation. It's really good, but as I said, that the deletion for the gene by using the CRISPR-9 is really good, really powerful. But repairing, we should think about it.
Thank you for your opinion, and of course, a lot of ethical concern. Thank you very much.
Some work, and then use the eyes. Some way the eyes is a good for the gene therapies.
Thank you.
And Luxturna. Luxturna is a drug has been developed for the autistic gemino. I don't know that. And now the one dose is ticket 300 euros, 300,000 euros. Only one dose. This is genetic therapies by using the virus. And the other drug now is going to come, and then the drug, they use the CRISPR-9 technology for the repair of the gene. But I'm not sure in the it's passed to the FBI or not. I'm not sure.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
This makes it
easier. Yeah. Mm-hmm. May I ask you one more question?
Yes, please.
Yes, so we know that in Turkey is a very well developed pharmaceutical industry. Are these companies doing some researches in order to implement some personalized medicines?
My knowledge is not. Because I think that for the personalized medicine, the big issue is patient really has a big variation of the DNA level. We can divide the patient based on the variation level. But when you move to the treatment protocol, they will not find enough drug or enough method which is equal to the variation level. So that's why mostly drug company work with a population, and then they choose the much more percentage higher level. So a rare disease or rare illness mostly will not choose for the pharmaceutic industry. In Turkey, there are a lot of pharmaceutical companies, most of them stated in Istanbul, also some of them stated in Konya also, but they mostly produced drug for the chronic disease, mostly. My knowledge is that there isn't any drug which I produced in Turkey related to the rare disease.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Some other patient?
Professor, may I also ask you a question?
Please.
Thank you very much for your very interesting presentation, and you're obviously a great specialist in this field and in this modern field of personalized medicine, which is so important now for our modern medical society. And I have a question which is very important for me personally. In cardiology, we deal a lot with personalized medicine in ablatogenomics. And how is this situation in your country with ablatogenomics? When before doing this expensive procedure of ablation, we should perform them the genomic test on the found mutations, which are important for the actual population. What is your opinion? What is the situation in your country?
Okay, actually, Ministry of Health every year send a document for the researcher, for the doctors, and then mostly the documents say that before you give this drug, you have to do this genetic test, especially for the cancer and the leukemia patients. But for the cardiovascular disease, I know that there isn't any restrict rule that explain first you have to do this genetic mutation, then you should do this operation. There isn't any rule, but some doctors also sent to the patient material to the genetic department to check the cardiovascular disease panels. We used also the cardiovascular panel in my medical genetic department. This panel has 167 different genes, and we checked the all well-known mutation, actually variation on the mutation, and also some the unknown mutation of that will be monitored after this panel. But a few doctors actually sent the patient material to our department, and then get result, and according to our result to monitor the or to operate the patients. Actually, it's not regular actually, but some of them do it.
Thank you very much, dear professor.
You're welcome.
Some other questions?
Mihail,
yeah.
You know that we are working with our center laboratory. Actually, next month I will finish all the draft projects. Maybe you will discuss all the project together, because not only the medical genetic department, also the, now I'm working with the BCL3 and BCL2 to laboratory for the virus. Also the stem cell, biobank, microbiology, let's see the animal house also, you know, that and animal behavior lab also. Maybe I think next week I'm going to finish all the projects, and then please discuss the project with your staff, and then after discussing, and then I will going to work on detail. Now this is just draft, and then I was going to work with the detail for per laboratory, and then the bench position, and then how many plug we have to put it, or on internet cables. There are a lot of issues actually. I have to do it next week, and next weekend you will find the final version of the central lab. Okay.
Okay. Thank you very much. Somebody found it. Other questions? Have somebody a question? So thank you very much, Professor Yusuf of school. So thank you very much.
Okay, you're welcome. See you soon. Take care.
Bye bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Так, где полиция?